Listen, Lonnie's fat ass sat on Fox Network for 8 years, and now she want to come to us with the bullshit? Girl, kiss our ass and suck our dick, please, respectfully.
Let's talk about it. It's all right. I'ma get some shit today. No, it's fine.
I'm not even about to make this a long video. Girl, fuck Lonnie Love. Fuck Lonnie Love. Let me just go ahead and share my screen so y'all can see exactly what the fuck I'm talking about. Okay, because Lonnie, we're not about to do this. We're not about to sit here and play this game with Lonnie. We're not about to sit here and play this goddamn game with motherfucking Lonnie. We're not about to do it. Okay, so I'm about to just jump right into it. Like I said, I'm not even about to make this a long video. I got shit to do today. It's fuck Lonnie Love. It's always been fuck Lonnie Love. And especially after this goddamn post, it's still going to be fuck Lonnie Love. And you're going to see exactly why. Okay, so let's go ahead and look at what the fuck it says. Okay, so the Shade Room posted, Lonnie Love sent out a tweet or whatever, and it said, I was on a show for 8 seasons and never got a birthday surprise. Dot, dot, dot. I am humbled for this. Thank you to my E! News fam. Dot, dot, dot. Clearly, as you can see, Lonnie was quoting a tweet from E! News that said, happy birthday, Lonnie Love. And then in the next slide over, you know, people commenting below, you know, like check back in this bitch, like, you know, didn't you have a whole happy birthday that said Samira and Lonnie? And Lonnie's like I said, 8 seasons, boo, never got one. That was a combo. Ooh. My God. Girl, fuck Lonnie Love. Fuck Lonnie Love. Fuck Lonnie Love. And the reason why it's fuck Lonnie Love is because what we're not going to do is this. What we're not going to do is this, especially after we all defended the real, because, you know, we all, and I mean, two things can be true. We know that Amanda Seals is problematic as fuck. We know. And we all defended the real when they chose not to leave Amanda, who was there for literally 30 minutes. You know, they chose not to put her into the last episode. So we rode for the real, okay? Hell, even after a lot of people and a lot of black people at that, it's really mostly only black people. Stop watching the real after Tamar left. We still kind of rode for the real because we were like, okay, at least they create, you know, they saved Tamar for the last episode, whatever. Da, 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 da. I'm saying all of this to say, like I said, fuck Lonnie Love, okay? Because when all of this shit was going down with Tamar, she was very quiet. Very, very, very quiet. And see, there was always rumblings in the streets, you know, that Lonnie was the true reason why Tamar got fired. Because see, Lonnie was promised that she would have her own show. And then I don't know what fucking happened behind the scenes of productions. Actually, I did know, but I forgot. Who gives a fuck? But I believe that it was something around the fact of like, okay, Lonnie, you are not marketable just on your own. So we need to see you in an ensemble cast, or we're not ready to see a big plus size woman on TV, you know, doing daytime talk. Like there was some type of excuse as to why Lonnie needed other women around her. Thus the real was created. Thus us having, you know, multiple different opinions, whatever. My problem is that as Tamar was going through everything that she was going through, nobody spoke up for her. Nobody spoke up for her. Even when Tamar was calling out the production company and calling out, you know, the bullshit and the producers behind the scene and this, that, and the third, nobody spoke up for her. But when Tamar was on the show, you know, Lonnie, you sitting there flirting with Vince and Tamar was your Ace Boon Coon and all of this, that, and the third. So 8 years later, I don't want to hear it. I don't want to hear it. I don't want to hear it. And I also have a big problem with people who go into these companies and go into these places. It's like y'all will sit here and get raped, cheated on, killed, and leave it up to you. Have had the worst experience ever, but we would have never known because your ass was clearly benefiting from it. Granted, yes, we are post-pandemic. Granted, yes, everybody needs a job. Everybody needs to survive. But what y'all not going to keep doing is sitting here and acting like you don't went through the worst thing ever. And then you benefited for however long amount of time. And again, granted, I'm not saying that Lonnie is sitting here making it seem like she benefited. No, I'm not making it seem like she is necessarily saying that Fox was like shitty, but it's just like, come on now. You just left doing the real. Now you got all of this slick shit to say. Now you want to do the slick comments. Now you want to throw shade. It's just like you literally just fucking left. And this is a platform that you benefited from for 8 years. Not saying that she doesn't have the right to an opinion and things like that, but if it mattered that deeply, you would have said something. We would have heard about this before. Not, again, 2 months after you just left the fucking company. I think it's whack. I think it's absolutely whack. I think, don't nobody give a fuck, because again, you should have been there for Tamar when Tamar was speaking out, instead of, you know, aiding in the process of making her look problematic and making her look like she was just out here just, you know, doing the fucking most for no fucking reason. It's just like, I don't like that shit. And that's kind of the same shit that Nene is doing. It's like, Nene, you was on a platform that clearly worked for you until it stopped working for you, and now all of a sudden you have a problem. I don't know. Maybe I'm making a mountain out of a molehill. I don't know. But for me, I just feel like out of all things for you to be mad at the company, you mad at them about a happy birthday. And then two, you never said anything publicly. You waited until now to say this shit. And then three, the one time that you do come out against them, it's over a fucking happy birthday. Not over Tamar getting fired unjustly. You know, not over, you know, the fact that soon as you guys, because let me be honest with you guys, y'all can sit here and say Tamar was a show. Tamar was a show. Tamar was not the fucking show. Tamar was not the fucking show. That show still went on. And mind you, I'm a Tamar stan. I love Tamar. I have a very special place in my heart for Tamar. But the show fucking went on, okay? The real fucking watchers of The Real, we were pissed for about 2 or 3 months after Tamar left. And then we realized, okay, the chemistry and the shit is still there. We didn't tune in for fucking Tamar, okay? Now, all the black people, y'all tuned in for Tamar because, you know, the whole 17 magazine gossip, y'all just couldn't resonate with that because there wasn't enough trauma bonding for you, okay? That's a separate video. I'm gonna drag y'all bald-headed bitches too. That's a separate video. That's why y'all couldn't resonate with The Real, because y'all wanted all of the trauma bonding and the ghetto fabulence of it all. And you know, that's not what The Real was. And, you know, Tamar, she did bring in a voice for us and bring in a voice for the Ratchets. And I get it. But let's be real. That's not what The Real was ever given. It was never given that. The Real was always given Cosmopolitan, Teen Vogue type of whatever. So even after Tamar left, the show still went on and was still successful. However, again, when Tamar was on it and was going through all those problems, nobody spoke up for her. Lonnie, you damn sure did not speak up for her. So it's like, for you to have these problems and all of this, that, and the third now, respectfully, shut the entire fuck up, okay? And we can even go ahead and go through the comments. Let's go through some of these comments and see what people are saying. So Lonnie Love says, under the Shade Room says, Lonnie Love thanked her E! News family for her special birthday surprise yesterday and shared that during her 8 seasons of The Real, she never got a solo birthday surprise. She's messy. Tamar was right. Let's see what they're saying about that, because I know people got controversial opinions about Tamar. Because all she said was she never got a special birthday shout out. You people are drama queens. No, we're drama queens, or is Lonnie Love the drama queen? Because clearly you tweeted that for a reason. You wanted attention. You knew it was going to make the blocks. You did 8 years of a show where you did gossip about the blocks. Come on now. Oh, and before I forget my original point, let's go back to my original point that I was making. My original point was, even though Tamar had left the show, she wasn't the reason the show got canceled. No. The show was still thriving and working without her. Okay? Even Tamara, as much as I love her, the show was working with Garcelle. Okay? Now, with Amanda, the shit almost got canceled. The reason why the fucking show was canceled was because after the pandemic, you cannot come back to a show that is built off of having a studio audience and not having a studio audience. They tried to take a mature approach that just did not work. They tried to become more of like a gossip pen, and it just did not work. The second they got rid of that studio audience was the second that they lost us. That's just it. Okay, so let me read a few more comments before I get the fuck off of here, because I said what the fuck I said. It's fuck Lonnie Love. Last year, this year, and in 10 years. I don't give a fuck. So, she tried to make a problem out of everything. My gosh, not her shade in the Real. She couldn't wait to bash the old show. I mean, you stayed on there though, but when they played with Tamar, y'all had no issues. So she was going to leave a job because they didn't tell her happy birthday. And see, here's my thing with y'all ignorant, retarded ass bitches. It's not about her leaving AJ. Well, yes, it is. Because see, that's part of my problem. Let's not sit here. Like, if you benefited from something, then shut the fuck up. Shut up. Nene, I don't want to hear about racism within a company. I don't want to hear about X, Y, and Z if you benefited from it. That's just like all of these Me Too movements and shit that come. Like, bitch, if you suck dick to get a career, I don't want to hear about how uncomfortable you felt sucking that dick, because at the end of the day, you benefited from it. That was the even exchange right there. The second that you put up with X amount of treatment and you still benefited or gained something from the other party, regardless of the treatment, that was an agreement that you willingly signed yourself into. So I'm sorry. I don't want to hear the, they never said happy birthday. Write that shit in a book. Okay? Write that shit in a book. Write that shit in Lonnie's Love Tales or whatever the fuck you want to call your autobiography of it. Write that shit later on. But don't sit here and try to be bitter now. And Nene, don't sit here and try to be bitter now. And sue the fucking I'm sorry. I'm just of a different cloth. I think differently. I don't know. But speaking of thoughts, listen, make sure that y'all stream my music as if y'all give a damn. And make sure that y'all comment down below with y'all thoughts on this situation as if I give a damn. Like I said, I just wanted to come in this bitch real quick and get my one twos about the situation. And that's it. It's always going to be fuck Lonnie because I don't like the bitch. Oh, look at me killing my career. Oh, well. And see, that is what we're going to go ahead and end this video. Now, remember, if you hated me for that opinion, don't worry, girl. There's a lot more where that came from. Just make sure that you like, you comment, and you subscribe and turn your notifications on. For extended videos and exclusive content, including full episodes of my new weekly podcast, Let's Start There, make sure that y'all go ahead and subscribe to patreon.com/ScottSantana. And also, make sure to y'all join the Bandit mailing list in the description box, so that way, y'all hoes never miss a video. Make sure that y'all follow me on Twitter so that we can engage and argue back and forth, and, you know, just stay tuned for the hot shit that's coming to you, bitch. Okay? I love y'all. Bye. Come and get your nut. It's all right. I'm gonna get some tension.